everybody at online.com/livewire.
Oh, we got a phone call?
Yeah. We got somebody joining us on the line. Speaking of mowing down zombies in an automobile.
Yeah, did a burnout on a zombie's head.
Damn right. Hershel Greene, played by Scott Wilson. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Oh, you make one mean cup of tea, my friend.
Yeah, it's a pretty good one, huh?
I was saying that this season so far, I think that was one of the best delivered, most moving scenes of the season
the
so
monologue.
Far. When you got the elderberries and you gave the whole speech about risk and everything. I mean, that was powerful.
Yeah, that was wonderful writing. I think Robert Kirkman wrote that, who founded they did the comic books that the show's based on. That was a lot of fun. It was a great, great scene, great episode for Hershel.
Now, how do you feel? Are you starting to almost get attached to those characters, Glenn and Maggie, who play, you know, your daughter and your kind of post-apocalyptic son-in-law? Do you find yourself, you know, caring for them as characters, hoping that they make it through episode to episode? Because right now, Glenn's on rocky ground.
Yeah, he's sick.
Yeah, he's sick in the prison. I pull for all of the characters, and I miss those characters that have been lost. I think that the surviving cast members are walking on their shoulders. It's because they really laid a solid foundation for the show to go forward on. So and the writers do such a great job. It's really wonderful.
Compared from season two, where they were on Hershel's farm, were you, I want to say xenophobic, but a little standoffish because you had to be to protect your family. Compared to now, where you are, you know, since Rick is essentially cracked, you've sort of become
starting to crack a
the patriot, you know, the how do I say, the paternal figure of this group. What do you think the biggest change is from season two, where you were introduced, up until season four with your character's personality?
Well, I think in season two, Hershel was, you know, telling people to get off his farm and things like that. But the solid reason for that was that he had walkers in the barn, his wife included, and friends and other, you know, in the barn. And he didn't want this group to stumble across the walkers in the barn, which ultimately they did. And Hershel found out that there was no turning back. Once you became a walker, you were a walker. And that changed his outlook and changed his life. He had suffered a lot of loss there in the second season. Lost his farm. His wife was finally lost. He knew she was lost. And his friends and the people that were working there with him at the beginning of the season. So he, like everyone on the show, has had suffered quite a bit of loss. It's an interesting part of the show. It kind of strips all of the rules that you have in society. It strips it down to who is the person and how does the person respond to the given situation that they're in, life-threatening situation.
And that's the beauty of the show because, you know, I was a little bit of a latecomer to it because I'm like, zombies, whatever. And zombies are one aspect of it, but then, like you said, you have the human aspect of it, the human relationships, the human turmoil, you know, everything that goes on with you know, the end of the world and human dilemmas and life and death. And it draws you in and on that human level and makes it, you know, so real and relatable. But Hershel has me worried because you did give the speech about the risks, and then, you know, you're going into the quarantined area, feeding them the tea, and then you're talking to the doctor, and it seems like Hershel is taking the risks, and he knows why he's taking them. But then, you know, you got the blood coughed on you, and it seems like he's almost...
His self-preservation instincts are starting to fall to the wayside.
Yeah, he's taking unnecessary risks. I'm worried. Is bad...
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, everyone in the show takes risk. The other guys who have gone out into the world trying to find some medicines for this, you know, to bring back to help people, and the people that stay at the prison are trying to keep the walkers out of the prison. So everyone is risking their life. Hershel is risking his. So it's really kind of and they're all risking their lives for the betterment of the group. So it's really a remarkable, you know, a remarkable group of people.
Before you got involved with The Walking Dead, were you a fan of the zombie genre from, you know, your Days of the Dead, Dawn of the Dead, or have you become
one
since?
I saw those films and I liked them, but I know when I got the call and they my representative said they're interested in you for this zombie show, and I said, okay, tell me some good news.
Yeah, no, right? You're like zombies, but then you probably, you know, got the backstory of the books and read the writing, and I would imagine you were immediately on board.
Yeah, I was. I mean, when you mention Frank Darabont and Gellan Hurd, your ears perk up and you say, yeah, that, let me see what we're doing here, let's see what's going on. And you talk to them, because those two people have been involved with some great movies. You know, so, and I think AMC was very insightful and very smart to take this show on.
I think it was really brilliant this year to add a third menace. You've always had the zombies from season one, then season two and three, we start to get the menacing humans with the governor.
Governor, yeah.
And then this season, yeah, we've got the disease now, which is just nothing you could swing at or shoot at or lock out.
And what a great job David Morrissey is doing, too, as well as being the bad guy, you know.
Well, I was going to ask, when are we going to see the governor?
He's
come
out
back
there.
Up?
He's
because
out there somewhere.
People are, I mean, that son of a bitch, people just despised. And we're so, on one hand, we're glad that they still have that antagonist, but people were pulling their hair out last season. Like, how did he get away? When are we going to get him back?
Right. I don't know, you know. What do I know? All I do is do my lines.
All right.
He's got no answers.
Scott Wilson, Hershel Greene, the patriarchal one-legged figure whipping up batches of elderberry tea, trying to get the prison back on track. My man, thank you so much for taking the time to talk
to
us this morning.
Have a great Halloween. StudyItOnline.com.